my Muslim friends, and they will say to us, well, the book you have is corrupted. But the question we have to ask you is, one, where's the proof? Number two, if you're making a claim, okay, you must first have the original to show the distinction between what's been corrupted and what's not. And not only that, where has it gone? Where has it disappeared to? Has it disappeared?
No, not necessarily. Yeah. If the book you have now, you can prove that it has even a single contradiction within it.
Right.
Then you can say, because by attribute, a book from God has to be perfect.
Okay, that's
contradictions.
Fine. That's
so
fine.
One way of looking at it is you can compare the old to new and say, has it been changed or not? But that's one thing. Another thing is to see if it's consistent. If it's inconsistent, that immediately negates
it
being from God.
That's fine.
That's fine.
But the Quran clearly says that we Jews and Christians, we don't have anything to stand up on unless we judge by the Torah and the Injil.
Right.
The Quran clearly says that. So if you're saying that our scriptures are inconsistent, if you're saying our scriptures are corrupted, then how can Allah make us stand on something corrupt?
Right, and it's almost as if you're disagreeing.
That's what the Quran says.
It's almost as if you're disagreeing with Allah.
Yeah, you disagree with Allah.
Specifically, have been sent to certain nations. Now, a new prophet, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, came.
It says it's Jews and Christians.
Do you want to read it?
Surah 568. Surah 568 says, those who follow.
Let me read it, you answer and respond.
Those who follow the messenger, the prophet who can neither read nor write, whom they will find described in the Torah and the gospel with them. Yeah? And then it says, you have no ground to stand upon unless you stand fast by the law and the gospel and all the revelation that comes from you. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So the Torah and the gospel. Right. Yeah, I want you to finish now.
Yes, yes.
The Torah was sent to a certain prophet, to a certain nation.
It doesn't say that. You have to prove that.
You're going to give us evidence. Like, we're going to show you evidence.
I'm giving the Quran to you.
Yeah, I'm giving you the Quran.
Yeah, go on. Say, show me where in the Quran it says that.
So the whole, and then
your conclusion would be it's irrelevant now because it's sent to those nations. It's irrelevant. Was that your conclusion?
So my conclusion is irrelevant because we have now another book which was sent by God, which is the final
one. You're going against your Quran.
That's why.
You're definitely going against your Quran. Show me.
Okay, bring evidence. We need to go with evidence. Yeah,
you're definitely going against your Quran. You're gonna.
The Bible and the Injil are not the same.
Sorry?
That's what I'm saying. The Bible and the Injil are not the same. That's what we're trying to say.
I didn't say that.
And the Torah.
We're not talking about the Bible. We said the Torah and the Injil. Okay.
No, you said you have evidence.
I did mention.
You said you have evidence.
Right. Yeah. No, okay, yeah. Let me explain what I said.
You said you have evidence from Dead Sea Scrolls or whatever that what you have today is the same as that.
Yes.
What you said.
Okay.
Yeah,
so,
I've seen it with my own
right. So what that would include the Torah. And would also include the gospel and Zabur. Yeah. So we have all of this. Okay.
Yes.
Obviously, where you may say that we different, there's a distinction is that we compile it in several books, which is the Biblos, the Latin term, the Biblos, which is a library of books, and so which we call the Bible. But what we're talking about specifically in this discussion is the Torah, the Injil and Zabur as well, yeah. But we're good then, let's talk about the Torah and the Injil.
According to who, we don't have it today. According to who?
Yeah, that's what I'm asking you. Yes, that's the question. Do you know? Why do we not have the gospel? If you say that the gospel is first of all, is the gospel changed? Has the gospel been changed?
There's evidence that
right.
There
can you provide us evidence that it's been changed?
Stuff being taken in or added.
What's your name, sir? What's your name, sir?
The fact that you have different books.
What's your name?
Maddie.
Maddie.
Yeah.
Godwin.
My name is
Daniel. Maddie, what we're asking is a very clear question. You say the gospel has been changed, corrupted,
yeah,
or lost.
Whichever. Yeah,
listen,
it's very important.
Listen, what's your name? Maddie.
Has one style has 66 books, one might have 70, so which one's...
Maddie, you're making a claim. You are saying, this is what you said. Hold on. This is what you just said.
What I'm saying is
when I say
Bible to one Christian and the Bible to another Christian, they're not...
That's fine. Maddie, you are making a claim that the gospel has been changed. Okay? Now, I'm asking you to provide evidence that it's been changed. And you can do it in any way. You can for sure it's the original gospel and say, oh, look, this is where the mistakes went wrong. Or Quran. You can show us where it's disappeared to or whatever, however you want to do it, but provide us some evidence so that we can say, okay, you, you know, there's proof. Show us through the Quran how it's provided. So show us your Quran.
Show us that our scripture, how our scripture is corrupted and changed according to your standard, which is the Quran.
Yes.
What does the Quran say about the Torah and the Injil?
Yes.
You can back him up.
You can come and help him. Stand right there. Stand right there. Go on. I want you. You stand right here.
No. You want to back him up?
No, if you know.
What's the question?
No, I'm saying if Muslims are here, we please help him, you know.
Help him
out. He might not know. Oh, he knows better than you. Okay, that's fine. But because you know, if it was a Christian, I'd help him as well. So if you can help him, help him. Yeah.
Any Muslim, if you know, help him out.
If you know, please give him help him out.
Help him out.
We're not trying to trap him. We just want to not understand why they say that.
Corrupted. Yeah. Where in the Quran?
Yeah, where in the Quran? That's a good. That's a. Because then if,
what's the
because,
right, we sent,
can you give us the surah and the ayah, please?
Yeah, we'll look at.
Surah Ma'idah, number 5. We sent following in the.
Surah Ma'idah. Can you tell us the number?
What number is it?
5. Verses? 13 to 15?
No, 40. 44.
Surah 5?
Surah 5, 44. You went to the chapter where it proves our point.
All right.
We sent following in their footsteps Jesus, son of Mary, confirming which came before them, the Torah. And we gave him the Injil, which was guidance and light, and confirming what was before. And then the next verse.
45?
And then let them...
Read to 47, isn't it?
Let them...
Read to 47.
48. Read up to 48.
Whoever does not judge by what
Straight
Allah...
Straight to 47, yeah?
Whoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, then it is those who are definitely disobedient.
What verse are you reading?
We have 48. 47. And we have revealed to you, Muhammad, the book in truth, confirming which proceeded of the scripture, and as a criterion over it. So judge between them by what Allah has revealed, and do not follow the inclinations away from what has come to you of the truth. To each of you we prescribe his law and method. Had Allah willed, he would have made you one nation, but he intended to test you in what he has given you. To Allah is your return altogether, and he will then inform you concerning that which you put over you to differ.
Okay.
So now this clearly states that the Quran is a criterion, which is a muhaymin, over the previous scripture. So now the question to you is, it says in the
hold on, let's just look at that again. Let's look at it very carefully.
Yeah, it says the previous verse, you should...
What verse?
47.
47, yeah?
The people at the time should judge with what Allah has revealed. Can you tell me...
No, it says very, very clearly, it says, let the people of the Injil.
Yeah.
Yeah? Well, so who's the people of the Injil?
The people, the one that Isa alayhi salam was sent to.
The Christians.
Right, so, yeah, the people of the Injil, the Christians, right?
Wait.
Christians?
This is a historical context.
Wait, let's clear it up what we're talking about. Is the people of the Injil the Christians?
They're not Christians.
So who are the people of the Injil? Who is he talking about?
Sorry? It doesn't say that.
It doesn't say that, no. Okay.
Does it say that? Surah 547, does it say that? It doesn't say disciples.
It doesn't say. It said
who
the
are they?
Who are the people of the Gospels? That's what I'm asking.
Which is the Christians?
No.
Who are they?
Who was Isa sent? Jesus sent to? He was sent to the children of Israel.
Okay. And the people of Israel.
Okay.
And the so children of Israel from Torah. Who are the people of the Torah?
The Torah was sent to Moses.
Right. So who are they?
Israel. Yeah.
The Israel.
Israel, yeah.
So Injil is for who?
So also sent to Isa. And
so this doesn't include Christians.
Christians came after, started.
Yeah, but does it include Christians?
If you don't know, ask a friend.
No, the only prophet that was sent to all mankind was Prophet Muhammad. The others were sent to the children of Jacob.
So it doesn't include Christians, yes or no?
No, but what do you mean by Christian?
I mean Christians. I'm a Christian. Yeah, yeah. Christian. Those who believe in Jesus Christ. Yeah. Your Quran clearly says people of the book are Jews and Christians.
Yeah.
People of the book are Torah and Injil.
Yeah.
So this includes Christians. Surah 547 includes Christians.
But what's your definition of a Christian?
Sorry?
What's your definition of a Christian?
Those who follow Christ. And that's not the point here. The point here is inclusive.
In what way do you follow Christ?
Well, we can talk about that. Yeah. That's a different
we can speak about that.
I don't want to go. I don't want to deviate.
It's very important because if you label yourself something.
No. You're deviating now.
Let me tell you why.
How scripture is corrupted. Don't deviate.
No.
Come on, bruv. Don't be slippery. Listen. What we're saying. Hold on. Let's clear this up. Listen what we're saying. Hold on.
Show me how you follow Jesus.
Sir, understand, sir. Let's bring this back. Yeah. What we're trying to understand, what we're trying to wrap our brains around, is this, right? Is you say that the gospel has been corrupted, changed, exactly. Lost, something of like that. You say the same thing with the Torah, okay? Now, I can give you my view, my subjective view on why you're saying this. The reason why you're saying this, or I believe Muslims say this, is because when we look at the gospel, and the gospels that we have, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Christians that claim that that's the gospels, and we look at the Torah, they contradict a lot of the information that we have in the Quran. And so you have no other choice but to say, well, hold on, listen, if I'm going to, hold on, oh yeah, I'll give lots. I'll give many. But let me just make that point, yeah? That there's so many contradictions, Jesus being God, Jesus dying on the cross, numerous, I can go on. But the point is this.
And you say Jesus is God, we don't say that.
Yeah, exactly. My point is that the Gospels we have contradict the Quran. And so you have no other choice but to say, well, it must be corrupt, it must be lost. But you have no way where Allah says that the Gospel the Gospel or Torah has been corrupted. We have no one saying that. We have Muhammad never ever says that in his sunnahs. Hold on.
It's a clear translation that the Quran is hold on.
One person. Do you want him to talk? One person at a time. I don't want. Yeah. Do you want him to talk for you?
It says it's a criteria.
Okay, let him finish. Finish.
What makes something a criteria? No. It means that what's before it is corrupt.
Right.
Wait, you need to slow down.
The people of gospel judge by what Allah has revealed therein. And whoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, then it's those who are definitely disobedient.
So are you judging by what's been said?
They're supposed to judge by what? What are Christians meant to be judged by? What are Christians meant to judge by?
By the gospel.
Right. Exactly. So what is the gospel? What was the gospel before
gospel
Muhammad?
Is what Jesus said. Did Jesus eat pork?
Right. Okay. So we're going back to you now. You're jumping. Where we are. Okay.
It's all about action.
You say you no longer have the Injil. How do you know what was in it?
Because this is my criterion. That's my point.
You know it? Listen. Okay. You say you don't have the Injil. So how do you know what the original was for you to say it's corrupted? How do you know the Quran's not wrong? How do you give us evidence?
There's only one Quran. If I go to anyone here, they will know exactly what the Quran is.
There's many Qurans.
But it's a different subject.
It's a separate topic. Yeah. We don't want to deviate. Yeah. The Quran clearly says, you have no ground to stand upon unless you stand fast on the Torah and the Gospel. Surah 568. Surah Maliyah 568. So how can your God... No problem. I'm explaining to you. How can your God say you have nothing to stand upon unless you stand on the law, which is the Torah, and the Gospel, if it's corrupted?
Because the people at the time are not following the Torah. That's the point.
Did you hear what you just said? Or did you hear what I said? I don't think you're hearing.
Yeah. Listen. Are you listening to the... Because the whole thing, in order for it to be a fruitful... Yeah, in order for it to be a fruitful discussion, we have to hear each other out. If we just bypass anything we're saying, then we're not gonna understand each other.
No, you don't understand.
So
it.
Let me tell you the problem you face.
No, look, it says wama unzila ilaykum mir rabbikum, which is this Quran.
Yeah.
Read
16.
And do not add to it.
No, 68.
Yeah, read 68, my friends.
Yeah, so what are you trying to say? He's saying that for the people before the Prophet Muhammad, if they believe in the true message of the prophets at the time, then they will have salvation. He's not talking about now.
That's what I said. You keep changing the subject. Stop changing subjects. Surah 568. Did you read 68?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
You read it in Arabic. You read it in Arabic.
It in Arabic. I don't read Arabic, but Arabic is right here.
That's what I'm saying. This includes the Quran.
Yeah,
Ali
Kitab.
No, it doesn't say that. So, all people of the book. It's not the Muslims. Yeah, that's how it starts. Say, all people of the book. You don't stand on anything until you observe the Torah and the Injil.
Yeah, this is the prophet telling the people at the time that you do not stand if you uphold what God, because it says at the end of the verse,
wrong. Do you know what it says? All people of the book.
He's speaking to the people of the book.
Who are they?
Who are they?
Who are they? Who are the people of the book?
Who are the people of the
book? Who say is the prophet?
Who?
Say is the prophet is.
No, it says people of the book. Who are they? Who are they? Identify them.
Right.
Right. The Jews and the Christians.
So it doesn't say at the time. Don't add your own words.
Don't add words to the Quran. You're adding words to the Quran.
Doesn't say at the time. All people of the book. People of
the Quran. I know
the Quran. Do you have a test
when
for
God
it?
Says, say, he's telling the prophet to say.
Okay. But do you have the tasfir that says only the people at the time?
Exactly.
You don't do.
Ibn Kathir say that?
Does Ibn Kathir say that?
I can bring it. I don't
know. No, but I'm saying to you that you're commentating and adding to the Quran, which is actually.
No, because are you saying this is irrelevant
for
today?
No, I'm saying to you, I'm reading your text.
Are you saying this scripture is irrelevant? There are no people of the book right now.
It ties in because the Quran is the Muhaymin now. The Quran, whatever laws it
contains. That's to the Muslims.
It's a Muhaymin over them.
That's to the Muslims. But to the Christians.
To the Christians,
we have to stand up on the Torah.
Come on.
You got no Torah.
You're saying that it's contradictory.
You got no Torah. The Bible, the Bible saying that got 5,000 errors, 5,000 mistakes.
Okay, but that's
in the Bible. In the Bible itself.
Okay, according to what standard? Your Quran says my Bible is not corrupted. Your Quran proves the preservation of the Bible. Sorry?
You're lying to me. The Quran is saying it deliberately. Change the word, twisting the word.
Change the what?
The word.
What word?
Who changed
the Bible.
So we're asking where does Allah say that the gospel or the Torah has been corrupted or changed? Can you show us where he says that?
From where? From the Bible.
You say the Bible. Yeah, whichever. You said the Bible, you claim that the Gospel or the Injil and the Torah has been changed. Where does Allah or Muhammad say this?
I think you were talking to that gentleman.
I've got the Quran.
Okay, so should we go back to what we're saying? So, hold on, one person at a time. Let's stick with him, yeah? So, it seems that we have a problem here because it seems that Muslims disagree with Allah. Allah says to you, and we've read it, I'll read a few of the surahs again, Surah 1094. Yes. Directed to Muhammad, says, if in doubt, ask those. You can check it out first. And you read it out. Surah 1094. Yeah, you read that. We've already read to you Surah 547.
Surah 1094 confirms that Islam needs authority from the Bible to exist.
Exactly.
For Muhammad to be prophet, they need the authority and judgment of the Bible.
You should go back to the Bible. That sounds perfect.
Okay, that's what
you're
saying, sir. Okay.
Yes. But you know what's interesting? I don't know if you're Muslims. Let's deal with that first, and then we'll go and move on. Yeah.
So
1094. Read it aloud. Read it in English for us. Can you read it out loud for us so we can hear?
Yeah, so if you are in doubt about what you have revealed to you, then ask those who have been reading the scripture before you. The truth has certainly come to you from your Lord. So never be among the doubters.
Okay.
Never be of those who deny the signs of Allah and thus be among the losers. Indeed, those upon whom the word of your Lord has come into effect will not believe, even if every sign should come to them until they see the painful punishment.
Okay, so what is that saying there? It says if you're unsure, go to where?
Go to
the people who were reading the scripture before you. Who was that?
Were the rabbi Muslim? Were they Jews?
Who is that rabbi becoming Muslim?
What's the name of the rabbi? We'll look him up.
Zacharias. Not a rabbi that became
Hey, you feel me, yeah? It's getting interesting.
What's the foolishness of God? Yeah? Is that foolish in the Bible?
From Ethiopia.
Yeah, so is anyone else can help him out? Can you, yeah, help him out, because we want to...
Let me read the verse,
yes.
So we can like be all in the same page.
Yeah.
So I read the verse. So, if you are in a doubt about that which we revealed to you, and ask those who have been reading the scripture before you. So, it is addressed to the Muhammad.
Okay, was he, where did he... Okay, just a minute. Yeah. Isn't that challenging?
So, Quran itself speaks and then says to Muhammad, if people are doubting the revelation I am giving to you, they need to go and ask the people of the book. Okay, so you don't go and check with any other caliph. You don't go and check with your wives. You go to the people of the book.
Yes.
He went to Abdullah bin Salam. Who is he? I'll tell you.
Give us the source.
He was a Jewish rabbi in Yathrib.
In the seventh.
Why are you showing?
Where's that source from?
It's saying because the foundation of God.
Can I read it? Do you mind?
You know, the rabbi of the Salam became Muslim. So they brought a verse in Surah Hud that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet to go and ask him, you know, there's prophecies in the Torah, in the previous scripture of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam coming.
Okay.
So he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, go and speak to them.
You're right. So can you, first of all, where's that? Is that a tasfir you're reading? Is that a tasfir?
Yeah,
we need a source. We don't want just hearsay. Yeah? And it has to be commentary on Surah 10:94. Yeah? Because we've never heard that before.
Where is this statement from? It can't be made, brother.
No,
it's
yes.
The Bible. It's wrong, bro.
What man
it's explaining. It's explaining to them
what
foolish
man
mind. That he's not saying God is foolish.
Yeah.
He's explaining to them. Yeah.
So have you got that?
God,
okay, what are you looking? I'm going to keep talking, yeah, just because we're filming as well. So, you know what's interesting about what you're saying is that, according to, I'll read it for you, Surah...
He's saying that this verse,
yes.
Is saying that for the Prophet Muhammad to go and look at the previous scripture, what are scriptures?
Yeah. This is what it's saying, yeah? You just read that if you're unsure, go to the people who are reading the scripture before you, okay? Now, we want
to
know... So we want to know. No, hold on, let me finish.
Let me finish.
If they have to go, if that's been revealed that they must go to the people reading the scripture before them, the only two people that we can think about is Israel. Israelites. Okay. So you said it's.
Abdullah ibn Salam.
Who is that? What is your source for that?
Yes.
Why is it in the wisdom of man?
Since Quran doesn't even mention that.
We've given many references. Surah 10:94, Surah 5:47. Yeah. So basically, what you're saying is that Allah's word can be changed. That's what you're saying. It's been corrupted, it can be changed.
No. Here's the thing.
Yeah.
Sir, here's the thing. Verse itself says, Muhammad, if people are doubting regarding the revelation I have given you, go to the they need to go to the people of the book. They've got the book. In 7th century, Christians have their scripture, so you need to go and check from their scripture. And remember, it's not like you go to the angel, you go to the caliphs, you go to the wives of Muhammad. It's you go to the people who were given the scripture.
But look at the context.
And we know Arabs were not given the scripture before. So it is Christians or Jews who has been identified as the people of the book. So can you give me your sources? Where did you come up with that name? Quran doesn't talk about
it's
that
in the
name.
Hadith. It's in the hadith.
Give me the source, sir. Give me the source.
In the Quran. No,
but I want to know what is the context
sir,
of this verse.
I
just want to know what is the context of this verse. I think go back to the people of the scripture for what?
Because
all of their
because people are doubting.
Listen, brother.
I want to answer your question, but yeah. When you overspeak me,
sorry,
when you shout at me, it just doesn't
help. I'm just trying to understand.
So, verse says, let me read it for you, which will help you. Okay. So if you are in a doubt, okay, about that which we have revealed to you. Muhammad, if you are in a doubt for what I have revealed to you. So what is revealed to Muhammad?
Quran.
Quran. So if you are in a doubt regarding the Quran, where do you go to? Do you go to the wife of Muhammad? No. Do you go to the Muhammad? No. So where do you go to?
What's the first?
Do you go to the Mansur? No.
Okay.
So you go to
Muhammad. No, Muhammad.
Okay, what's the verse before
if
that?
You are in a doubt, no. Tafsir is to Muhammad. So
what's the verse?
Who is it talking to? For centuries, you interpreted this verse as Muhammad. Now, right now,
what's
right now you are denying.
It's about his prophethood. The prophethood. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
says. Is that the context that you're saying?
No, it's the prophethood. So he goes to the rabbis.
Oh, that makes sense.
No.
You go back to rabbi.
Listen.
Let the Quran
your own
speak.
Book.
Previous book.
Okay, guys, no.
Guys, let's not make it our opinion. Let's just see what the Quran says.
So
we're gonna read the Quran and see what the Quran
says.
Hold on. Listen.
What does the Quran represent to the prophet?
What
does the Quran represent to the
prophet? Just a minute.
The prophet.
We'll go to that in a minute. Let's look at the Quran.
Sorry, what's your name?
Mehdi.
Mehdi, my name is Satun, nice to meet you, sir. So, when you let Quran to speak itself, so, if you are in a doubt about that which we have revealed to you, so, what is revealed to whom? What is revealed to whom?
His prophet and his Quran and the Quran.
So, yeah. Quran is revealed to Muhammad.
Yeah, and that is a prophet. Okay? And that is a prophet.
Sorry?
Prophethood.
It doesn't say that, sir. Why are you? What is revealed to you?
Does it say Quran?
Of course, I'm just reading the verse because you know much better than me as someone who is engaged with Dawah. You probably know much better than me.
Wait.
Every verse in the Quran is well explained. Quran is well detailed. There is no contradiction in it. Quran itself says so. So when you look at the verse, which my phone just gone off, if you are in a doubt about that which we have been revealed to you, what is revealed to Muhammad is the Quran.
Islamic holy book. That's a tafsir.
Just a tafsir.
Okay.
So okay, I want explanation. Sir, if Quran is well explained,
what does the Quran say?
If Quran is well explained and well detailed, can you just tell me what is it that it is revealed to Muhammad? What is that thing?
His prophethood.
Quran doesn't say that. Quran doesn't say that.
Quran doesn't say he's a prophet.
No. This verse does not say that if people are doubting regarding your prophethood, that's Surah 7. You are getting confused. You are getting confused. Surah 1094. No, that was Surah 7, sir. I'm sorry. I have to help you with your basic Islamic knowledge. But here's the thing.
Very basic.
So if you are in a doubt about that which we have revealed to you, then ask those who have been reading the scripture before you.
Simple.
The truth has certainly come to you from your Lord. Yeah. So never be among the doubters.
So if
you are in a doubt regarding the Quran, because that is the revelation given to Muhammad.
It's a tafsir again.
Okay.
So what's been revealed?
What is revealed to Muhammad?
That he's a prophet.
Show us where he's a prophet.
Where is it?
No. Show us.
This verse doesn't say that.
I said it three times.
I read the verse maybe minimum three times. Okay? This verse does not say that. So, why are you using
it? He revealed to him a message. It's a message.
Hold on a minute. I just tried to interpret the verse. Throughout centuries, half Muslims interpreted it. But now you are denying that. So can you just give me the verse which says we reveal to Muhammad his prophethood?
I'll tell you what you do. I'll make it easier. Go to look at the context and then show us where it says prophethood. Look at the context. Because you're saying you're denying what the Quran says. So you go and show us where it is. Then read it. Don't make up stuff. Read it.
So he's saying here, in
Quran, about the book.
So if you're in doubt, no, Muhammad, about what you have revealed to you, then all those who have been reading the scripture.
Referring about the
message.
Prophethood.
Yeah. Prophethood and Islam.
So that's what it means.
Yeah. Sorry?
They've input the word Quran.
Sorry?
What they're trying to say here.
What the Quran
what they're trying to say here is that just because
you can't, interpret the Quran,
you can't. You need some seed there.
Hold on a minute, 2 minutes ago, I used the tasvir to explain it to you, and then you told me, and you told me to not do that. But now you have to go to the tafsir to explain that. Let me read one of the famous tafsir, Ibn Kathir. Sir, would you like me to read the Ibn Kathir for you? 94. Sir, would you like me to read the tafsir for you? Sir, would you like me to read the tafsir for you?
We're looking at tafsir.
We're having a clear misunderstanding. Just, I'm saying the message sent to the Prophet Muhammad
sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, FIR.
It's not tafsir. He finds, go to the, if you look at Bukhari 4.
I'm not talking, sir, I'm not going to something which is written 200 years after the death. So, Quran supposed to explain me well. Just tell me, where is in this verse? Where is in this verse?
We believe in the Quran and the Hadith. So
where is it in this verse,
listen
Quran?
Carefully.
Where is in this verse, which is from the Quran, which is from the word of Allah, it says, revelation is Muhammad's prophethood.
I mean, where can I ask you, why is it taking so long for you to answer? Very simple question. Come on, ask your friends to help you. It seems that you're taking all the hits. Come on, guys, help him out. Very, very simple. The question is, do you understand the question? Yeah, because you've been struggling for a while.
You're dangerous.
Do you have enough? Let him step on. Let him go.
Hold on, A Muslim who is engaging with Dawah just calls me dangerous because I just read from the Quran. Why do you call me dangerous, sir? I just read it from your Quran, and I am asking you a very simple question. That's a very simple question. Show me, sir.
You want a certain answer, you're not listening.
I am asking a very simple question. Just give me a simple answer. Where does it in the verse it says that?
Repeat your question, please. Repeat your question.
Okay, this is last time, okay?
For the last time, yeah?
This is
your question. I want all of you to stay quiet, yeah? So that we can have a clear answer.
Okay.
Who's going to answer out of all you guys?
Okay.
You will, yeah? Are you sure? So you guys don't interrupt him when he answers, yeah? No. I don't think you trust him. You need to trust him. No. Please, wait for a minute. We're going to shoot it together. So she's going to ask the question. Thank you. She's going to, I'm just trying to make things easier. His brother. His brother. You respond to the question, yeah? We don't want everyone talking at the same time, yeah? So she's going to ask the question.
The internet on your side. It's only asking. No problem.
Surah 10 verse 94, which states, Allah speaks, okay? So, if you're in, brother, so if you're in a doubt about that which we have revealed to you, then ask those who have been reading the scripture before you. The truth has certainly come to you from your Lord. So never be among the doubters. So this is the verse. My question is...
Wait, she's asking now.
I haven't asked my question. So the question is this. If Bible is corrupted word of God, if Bible is not reliable, why Islam needs a confirmation for Muhammad's prophethood, Islam needs a confirmation for Islam's holy book and revelation of Islam from the people of the book, which were they were reading same Bible in 7th century.
Okay, so who's gonna answer? Who's gonna answer? One person. You answer?
Liar.
They're pointing at you. You got the heat now. You got the spotlight.
I've got the truth.
You got the spotlight. Okay. So you answer. No one interrupts you. Yeah?
So you made a claim. So in that question, you made a claim that they were reading the Bible. So that's what I'm going with the first question. The source is the Bible that we have today, the same one that they're referring to. Secondly, Bukhari 4546 clearly states, authentic narration, that Prophet Muhammad Abdullah bin Salam was a rabbi in Medina, spoke to the Prophet Muhammad and asked him certain questions. There's a hadith you can check here.
Yeah.
Actually, if you want me, I can read it out.
I have to respond to that. Yeah. Sir, maybe do you want to take 2 minutes? 2 minutes, that would be
easier. Yeah, yeah, that would make it easier.
I need to go on press.
Okay.
All right, do you want to take your goal? You want to continue this? Okay, we're going to do this. What we're going to do, because we want to have some order.
Read the hadith for us.
2 minutes and then 2 minutes, okay? Are you okay with that?
Let him to finish first. Let him to finish first.
All right, all right.
Because I have to respond. You made claims, I need to respond to them, sir.
Yes.
Yeah, so the hadith of, I can read the whole thing. When Abdullah bin Salam heard the arrival of the Prophet at Medina, he came to him and said, I am going to ask you about three things which nobody except the Prophet would know. What is the first portion of the hour? What will be the first meal taken by the people of paradise? And why does the child resemble its father, and why does it resemble its maternal uncle?
Yeah. Do you mind if I use your phone to read? To see what you are reading? Sorry.
Yeah. 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, continue. I'll follow as you read it.
So he, Gabriel, from amongst all the angels, is the enemy of the Jews. Allah's apostle, the Prophet said, the first portion of the hour will be a fire that will bring together the people from the east to the west. The first meal of the people of the paradise will be extra long. And as for the resemblance of the child to his parents, if a man has sexual intercourse with his wife and gets discharged first, the child will resemble the father. And if the woman gets discharged first, then the child will resemble him. On that, Abdullah bin Salam said, I testify you are the apostle of Allah, Abdullah bin Salam, the Jews are liars and they should come to know about my conversion to Islam.
Okay, Mehdi, can I respond to you now? Here's the thing, here's the thing. I read from your own Quran, Surah 10, verse 94. And then I ask you, how does this verse disprove the Bible? Okay? You went to the Sahih Bukhari. Just I'm rephrasing.
She didn't say that. You've got to be honest.
Afterwards, you respond.
She said, this verse.
It's her time too. I'm not cutting you. Let her finish and then you
respond. You went to Sahih Bukhari.
So we carry on a false premise.
You will rebut with a false premise afterwards.
You went to Sahih Bukhari. You went to Sahih Bukhari. And in that story, someone is asking, if you are prophet, this is my top three question you must answer. Guys, have you heard the hadith? One of the questions is, what is the first meal in paradise?
Fish, liver of the fish.
That's the second question. That is the question. That is one of the questions, three questions. One of the questions for people to identify Muhammad as a prophet, Muhammad needs to tell people, what is one of the first meal in paradise?
Yeah, who would know that?
Let me finish. As Muhammad said, first meal in paradise is the fish liver. I think that's what he said. And then
he didn't say that.
Fish liver, something like that,
yeah,
sir.
Yeah,
you check that out.
Does Allah
confirm that in the Quran? No.
No.
Allah doesn't tell us.
We don't have everything. In
Allah. Hold on.
You're going to talk in a minute. Wait.
Criteria for Muhammad to be prophet, he needs to know three things. There are three questions. One of the questions is, what is the first meal in paradise? Muhammad makes a meal and then says, guys, fish and liver. Does Allah confirm that in the Quran? No. Allah silent that in the Quran. But here's your problem, brother. Here's your problem. Hold on a minute. My question was to you from the Surah 10, verse 94. One of the way you should have responded to that is, you needed to go to the hadith which this verse is revealed. You needed to go to... So you don't have the hadith which this verse is revealed. Surah 10, the hadith you quoted has nothing to do with Surah 10, verse 94. So I'm gonna ask my question again. What is it? Surah 10, verse 94 talks about. We have revealed to you. What is that thing? And if that is the Quran, because you don't have that much option.
No, give it up. It's Muhammad is the messenger of Allah.
So is he speaking about Surah 1094?
I'm asking Surah 1094.
It's a specific question.
He said, how does the prophet?
We're looking for Surah 1094. The hadith of Prophet.
This is utterly, basically, one line what you're saying. You're saying that because it says there to go to speak to this, to go and read the other people of the Quran the scripture, that means that the scripture you have today is exactly what was sent back then. That's not the point. The point is for the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to go and see what has revealed to him, what's been revealed to him, the Quran's been revealed to him, that he's a prophet, that he's been sent to mankind. These are all encompassed into that one verse. How we praise, etc. And so go back to them and you will see that they have prophecies. They will have prophecies that confirm that you are the prophet.
Yeah.
And you have that in
okay, let me respond to that. Brother, let me respond to that. Let me respond to that. I am amazed as a Muslim at Speaker's Corner. As a Muslim at Speaker's Corner who engages with Islamic Dawah does not even tell me what is the context of Surah 10 verse 94. That is shocking and disturbing. So, let me respond to that. If this verse is talking about Muhammad is a prophet which has been prophesied in the Bible, if this verse is talking about Quran is the revelation from Allah, which has been revealed, which has been described in the Bible, let me tell you what Bible says about Muhammad and the Quran. Sir, can you hold this for me?
So
Bible talks about prophets. Okay. Hear what Bible says. I'm sure you can identify this very well. I'm reading from the Gospel of Matthew, which is written by the disciples of Jesus in the first century, chapter 24. Then you will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death, and you will be hated by all nations because of me. At that time, many will turn away from the faith and will betray and hate each other, and many false prophets will appear and deceive many people. At that time, if anyone says to you, look, here is Christ, or there he is, do not believe it, for false Christ and false prophets will appear and perform great signs and miracles to deceive even the elect. If that were possible, see, I have told you this before. Yes, Jesus himself talks about Muhammad as a false prophet who comes and denies the Christ. Islam comes and denies the Christ. Islam comes and undo the work of Lord Jesus. Jesus tells us.
You just said if someone comes and claims he's the Christ,
No. If someone comes at that time, if anyone says to you, look, here is Christ, or there he is, do not believe. False Christ and false prophets will appear and perform great miracles and deceive people. Muhammad is identified as a false prophet. Muhammad is identified as false prophet. Bible talks about it. So here's my question, still stands. Surah 10, verse 94. What does it say? Surah 10 verse 94, sir. Give me the context. Sir, let me speak. Have a little bit respect. Sir, can you please provide the answer for me? Oh, you don't know?
No, your
point is. So that was the topic I asked for this question.
This book is not the same in Jude.
This is the book.
No, it's not.
Let me respond. This is the Bible. There have been different books.
Because Allah says, we have revealed.
Let me respond. You just made a claim about my book.
Allah says, we have revealed the Injil to Jesus. Was this given to Jesus?
I'll respond.
Was this given to Jesus?
Can I respond? So you ask me a question, let me respond. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to just clarify the mess.
You're welcome.
Jesus is, sorry, Jesus,
which version is that?
Sir, your brother just asked me question. Can you please allow me to respond the question?
Can I ask any question?
Jesus is the eternal word of God. This book is the revelation to the word of God. This is the written version of the word of God. This was book exists Genesis to Revelation before Muhammad. This was the book Christians had in their hands at the time of Muhammad. This was the book even British Library has from the 320s. This is the book which is compiled in the beginning of second century, which has been sent out in the first century, which is written down in the first 30 years of the...
Why have books been taken out? Books been added?
Back up your claims. Jesus is the goodness. Jesus himself is the angel. There was never a time God gave a piece of religion to Jesus. Jesus is the goodness. Jesus is the angel, sir. You've got to wake up for that. Give me your source. Tells you that this is the book. This is the book. Allah gave it to Jesus. Here's the evidence. Give me two eyewitnesses to that. Give me two eyewitnesses.
Eyewitnesses that was given to...
Only two eyewitnesses. I'm asking only two eyewitnesses.
Two eyewitnesses. You put his phone right back in his pocket.
No, I've got the verse.
You got the verse. Okay, use it. We want to bring it up.
This verse... The Injil that we believe in.
I am asking two eyewitnesses. Why can you not provide me two eyewitnesses? They saw there was a piece of book given to Jesus.
Yes, we want to see that.
Can you provide us with two eyewitnesses?
Can you provide two eyewitnesses that Paul saw the things? Paul saw Jesus.
Sir,
because you have double standards.
Guys, have you noticed what your Muslim brother does?
Yes.
Muslim is who engage with Islamic dawah fails to respond to question and change the topic.
What you're saying is, I'm wrong, so you're wrong too.
No,
we're saying is, anything you ask for, you want evidence.
Give me your eyewitness. Prove me there was a book given to Jesus. Prove me pieces of paper.
If you can't,
I'll give it to you. Guys, take it.
Can you do it?
God clearly says it in the Quran.
Can you give us two witnesses?
This look.
Where does it?
If you can't,
you're breaking that criteria yourself.
You said. Allah give Jesus book.
Yes.
Okay. For me to believe that, because my scripture, previous books, which Quran came to confirm, tells us Jesus is the goodness. Jesus is the angel.
If there was a book given to Jesus,
I want you to provide two eyewitnesses.
You made a claim.
Two witnesses that Quran says those are the people who saw a piece of book was given to Jesus.
So can we deal with that question? Yeah, before we move on. Do you have eyewitnesses?
You don't have
eyewitnesses.
Okay.
That's cool.
If you don't have eyewitnesses, then let's move on.
I don't need the two eyewitnesses, man.
This book.
May Allah guide you. You're gonna go this path. You're gonna go straight into the hell.
You know what? I have been already washed by the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross for me, sir. It is shame that your book denies that. But here's the thing. As you deny that, as your book denies that, as you struggle to find Muhammad, as you struggle to get the authority from the Bible regarding the Quran, Quran tells us, Quran came to confirm the previous revelations. Quran came to confirm the previous revelations, sir.
and previous revelation tells us you are sinful human being like me and you need to repent and come to the Lord Jesus. There is no any other way for you to spend eternity in somewhere else. That's again, Quran lies again. Quran lies again. But here's the bottom line. Quran came to confirm the previous revelation, and previous revelation identifies Jesus as the Lord. Previous revelation identifies Jesus as the Lamb of God who dies on the cross for your sins, sir. This is your opportunity. At Speaker's Corner, you had the opportunity to hear the gospel to repent. It's up to you, sir. We love to see you in heaven, but God is not going to force you to be there. Keep on, keep on.